you think of the show?
Oh, I loved it. It was very entertaining. He was well talking, like very well vocal wise.
Anyways, did you have a favorite part of the show?
Just actually being involved with it was very nice. Otherwise, seeing everybody, the little guy acting like a velociraptor and stuff, and then the boomerang was pretty cool.
So, okay. Anything else?
But I would definitely recommend for people who are skeptical about it to just try it. Okay. Just try it. Definitely try it. It's something fun.
Okay. So. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Think of the show?
I had a great time.
Okay. Did you have a favorite part of the show?
I liked it when we were all animals.
Okay. How do you feel right now?
I feel relaxed.
Okay. Anything else?
I had a good time up there.
Okay. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen in the audience, I think we've got a show. Give your friends and family a big round of applause. A big round of applause. They're up here to entertain you and have fun for themselves. While you're up here, I want you to remain comfortably seated upright. No floppy bunnies. The only people that like you falling out of your chairs are lawyers. All right, so go ahead, stay safely, comfortably in your chair at all times. Engage your imagination. And the first thing I would like you to do, please, if you would, is create the imagination that there's a pesky woodpecker flying around your head. Flying around your head, bat him away. Bat that woodpecker away. You can move while you're in hypnosis, and he lands right on your shoulder, and he's looking in your ear. Bat that bird away. Bat that woodpecker away. You can move. You can move while you're in hypnosis. Swat him away. Swat him away. And he comes up to the top of your head, and he lands on the top of your head. A couple of you got a smooth head, and you feel those little claws. Brush him away. You can move while you're in hypnosis. You can move while you're in hypnosis. Brush him away. Go ahead and close your eyes. Go ahead and close your eyes, but brush him away. You can get that woodpecker off. That's right. That's right. But he comes back. Brush him away again. Brush him away again. That's right. Just get him out of there. And then, oh my goodness, I'm sorry I bumped you. Oh my goodness, you've now got flies coming in. I don't know, it's a hot summer day, what might be attracting them, but get those flies away from your face. Brush them away, shake your head. That's right, get those flies away. And here comes the woodpecker again, right at the back of your neck. Who knows what the woodpecker might do? Get them off the back of your neck. Get them off the back of your neck back here. Get them off, that's right. Okay, whoosh. The wind catches them both, takes them away. We're getting them engaged in their imagination. Give them a round of applause as they learn how to be in hypnosis. Now, here is a funny thing that's going to happen. It's unusual, but go along with me here. Have it be as if your feet are getting hot. One of you is already barefoot, but your feet are getting hot. You need to get those shoes, those sandals, those flip-flops off. Don't kick them far away. Don't kick them far away, but get them off. Get your shoes off. You can move while you're in hypnosis. Get your shoes off. If you're only wearing socks, get your socks off. But get those shoes or socks off, and when they're off, go ahead and wiggle those little piggies. Wiggle those little piggies. It feels so much better. Go ahead and finish getting your shoe off. Finish getting your shoe off. Get it off. Get the other one off. That's right. Oh, and it feels so much better. Feel how fresh and relieved your feet are. And now something amazing is going to happen with those shoes. Go ahead, briefly open your eyes, reach down and grab a flip-flop, grab a shoe. If it's not yours, you can borrow somebody else's. But go ahead, reach down, open your eyes, grab a shoe. That's right. Grab a shoe or your, okay, there you go. And bring it up. I know you didn't kick your shoes off. Get one of those shoes off. Get one of those shoes off. There you go. And bring it up. Go ahead and close your eyes. One, two, three, and sleep. Deeper, more focused, relaxed, very good. And bring that shoe up to your ear. Bring your shoe up to your ear, and your favorite music starts to come out of it. Your favorite music starts to come out of it, and you start bopping along with that music. you start bopping along. For some of you, it might be techno, might be country, might be rock and roll, could be classical, I don't know. But just bop along with it, move your head. You might even start humming with it. It is fun. It is exciting. And we're going to find out what people are listening to. If I'm talking specifically to you, I'll touch you on the shoulder. What music are you listening to, young man?
Rush E.
Rush?
E.
Rush E. Rush E. Terrific. And what's the title of the song? Do you know?
Rush E.
Rush E. There you go. That's the title. Terrific. Some of us up here are old. Rush E, everybody. What are you listening to, sir?
Ronald by Falling in Reverse.
There you go. Falling in Reverse. What are you listening to? You don't know? Do you got any music coming out at all? Do you want to stay on stage or do you want to go back into the audience? Give her a round of applause for giving it a try. Sir, what are you listening to?
Way Down We Go.
Oh, there we go. Way Down We Go. That's right. What are you listening to? What? That's okay, but are you enjoying the music? You want to go back into the audience? Go ahead and do that. Ma'am, what are you listening to?
Nothing.
Go ahead, in your imagination, your favorite song. Your favorite song. Just feel it starting to come to you. You hear it in your head. What's the song now? I'll come back to you. Go deeper into hypnosis, more creative, more having fun. What are you listening to here?
Nothing.
That's fine. Oh, you got it. Go ahead. There you go. This way. Now the speaker's up there. Go ahead and listen. There you go. What are you listening to?
Dirt on My Face.
What are you listening to, dude?
Nothing
too? Okay. What are you listening to in that shoe?
Rushy.
Very good. What are you listening to, young man?
Put You Through Me.
All right. And over here, young man, what are you listening to?
Subversion Army.
I gotta listen to some of this music. Go ahead, keep on listening, but the most amusing thing is going to happen. Even for the adults who this might not be quite be true, but let it be a pleasant sensation for you, it changes. It's a telephone. It's your mom on the phone. It's your mom on the phone, and she is not happy. She is not happy. She's talking to you. She's complaining about something. What is your mom talking to you about? Okay, tell you what, I know. Tell you what, listen to me. Let the mother's voice fade. Everything is fine. Everything is fine. And after the show, if you want to talk about it privately to me, we can deal with it, all right? Go back to listening to your music. Got it? Go back to listening to your music. Happy, happy, enjoy the music, let it go. All right, what is your mom upset about?
My brother.
Your brother, now without going into any details, do you think mom's right or do you think the brother's doing okay?
My mom.
Your mom's right. Yeah, that's the safe answer. Very good. Well, you go ahead, keep on listening. Dude, if you could talk to your mother, what do you think she'd talk about?
Me.
You? All right, cool. Hey, listen, we've all had mothers. Do you think she's right, or is she full of hot air?
I'd like to say she's full of hot air, but she's not.
She's not. You and I had very similar mothers, dude. Hey, what's your mother saying?
Nothing?
Well, you're lucky there. What does your mother say?
Nothing.
All right, cool. What's your mom say?
Nothing.
That's fine. And over here, dude, you're listening to your mom. What does she have to say to you?
Nothing.
Nothing. I think she had a little bit going on there. Give them a round of applause for the creativity. Terrific. Now, here's the deal. Tattoos are cool. Go ahead and bring your phone, shoes down. Go ahead and bring your phone and shoes down. Tattoos are cool. The person that I'm touching on the shoulder right now, I know you've got tats already, but you're going to have a brand new tat. Everybody else, if you want to open your eyes, you can. We'll take you back into hypnosis. But you go ahead, open your eyes, and come up and join me in the front of the stage. All right. How old were you when you got your first tattoo?
18.
Fantastic. And what was the first tattoo you got?
On my hip is the two female symbols linked together.
Linked together, terrific. What I want you to do, you can stay standing while you're in hypnosis, and I'm gonna have you go back deep into hypnosis, where I'm gonna create something very imaginative. One, two, three, and sleep. Deeper, more focused, relaxed. I am going to have you imagine a brand new tattoo. A brand new tattoo right here. Right here. And you are super proud of it. And it is colorful. It's going to amaze you. You're going to absolutely love it. Now here's the cool thing about this skit. As the little girl gets quieter and quieter, here's the deal. This will not become a compulsion for you to get a tattoo like this at all. But I want you to, in your imagination, create a fantastic, colorful, exciting tattoo. One, two, three, raise your head. And so the first one was when you were 18, two female symbols. I think that is so cool. But guess what? One, two, three, look down at that arm.
It's like a grizzly bear, and it has like the Rocky Mountains in the background with all the colors, like colorful Colorado.
Yeah,
it's so with pine trees, mountains, snow. Wow.
What?
It almost like it's a patch tattoo. Like it's like a patch on my skin, not like an actual ink.
It looks
like it's sewn on.
Oh yeah. Show the audience right over here. Everybody, take a look. It is vibrant. It's like 3D.
Yeah, like I said, it's like a patch. Like when you're in Girl Scouts and you get the patch put on your vest, it's like they sewed it on my skin.
Is that great?
Oh my goodness, yes.
Now, it's none of my business. You don't have to tell us. How much would a tattoo like that cost?
Oh, at least five plus.
Five plus, yeah. 5,000 or more.
No, 500
or more. Dude, wow. Where did you get that work done?
Body Candy in Omaha.
Body Candy in Omaha, yeah. Have you ever gone to a tat convention?
No, I really
love them. Oh, they are so cool. I will hook you up with a friend of mine whose name is Mikey, and he knows where all the greatest conventions are, and he knows one of the finest tattooists in the world. Comes to the United States at a few select. So if you want me to put you in touch with Mikey, talk to me after the show, all right?
That's awesome.
It is. Okay, show us one more time. It is like 3D. Flex your muscle a little bit. See what happens. Is that cool?
It's awesome.
Awesome. Okay, go ahead and have a sit. Tell you what, sit right there for me. Everybody, look at me. You can go back into hypnosis just for me, just for this show. When I say one, two, three, sleep, and snap my fingers. One, two, three, and sleep. Deeper, more focused, relaxed, all the way down. I'm gonna do a little bit of housekeeping. Person I'm touching on the shoulder right now, go ahead and open your eyes, and go ahead and move to that chair over there. One, two, three, and sleep. Deeper, more focused. Person I'm touching on the shoulder right now, just go ahead and scoot over one chair to your left. Fantastic. Give them all a round of applause, everybody. That tattoo, that's the most vivid tattoo I've seen for a while. Here's what we're going to do. Person I'm touching on the hand right now. From now on, even though you go deep in hypnosis and you're very creative and you're going to have a lot of fun with some of these skits, if I ask you about the show, you're going to tell everybody it's fake. It is fake. This is the silliest thing. These people, they're not in hypnosis. Even if you've been deep, deep, deep in hypnosis, the deeper you are, the more you're going to tell us this is fake. No matter what you see, no matter what you experience, if I talk to you about it, this is fake. If you'll do that, just nod your head. Terrific. Fantastic. All right. Would you like to go back into the audience or go back into hypnosis? All right. Go ahead. Give him a round of applause for giving it a try. Everybody, twice as deep all the way down. There you go. Excellent. All the way down. What I want you to do, person I'm touching on the shoulder right now, go ahead, open your eyes and stand up. Join me at the center of the stage. Join me at the center of the stage. Very good. Let's stay away from the edge a little bit right here. right here. All right. What I'm going to do, you're going to be able to go into hypnosis standing up, all right? 1, 2, 3, and sleep. Deeper, more focused, relaxed. Everybody else, again, you can open your eyes. If you come out of hypnosis, that's fine. I'll take you back in. But this is what we're going to do. In a moment, I'm going to show you the hypnotic boomerang. And I'm going to throw it out there, and it's going to go around the poles, come back, bounce off that bouncy house back there, come all the way back to us, going around each of the poles in front of us, and it's finally going to come and very gently but definitely bounce right off your forehead and take you back into hypnosis. But it's going to amaze you the entire time that it's flying out there. 1, 2, 3, open your eyes, open your eyes, open your eyes. Look right here. Look right here. That is my hypnotic boomerang. It is made out of the Bilibili tree of Australia. And it is rare, it is precious, and I have imbued it with the power of hypnosis. Do you believe me? All right, cool. I'm going to throw it out there. It's going to arc around. It's going to do some acrobatics. It's going to bounce off that bouncy house there. Then it's going to come back and it's going to weave between these poles. And then it's going to pop you right there. And you're going to go right back into hypnosis. Pretty cool, huh? Guys, what do you think about the hypnotic boomerang right here? Is that cool? Was that cool? What? You don't think so? Well, let's find out. Are you ready? Here we go. Here it comes back, that first pole, the second pole, right over the dog there. Oh, it almost got the tail, right there across, and went, boom. Deeper, more focused, relaxed. Dude, did you see all that stuff it did?
Yeah.
What do you think?
That was pretty cool.
That was pretty cool. All right. Did you see what that boomerang did?
No.
No? Come over here. You'll get a better sight over here. You'll get a better sight over here. All right. What did you think of the hypnotic boomerang?
I think it's fake.
Fake? What do you mean? It's made out of the Bilibili tree. It is beautiful. It's wonderful. Why would you say that's fake?
Because it is.
What do you think of her?
She has her own opinion.
Yeah, okay, your own opinion. All four of you, 1, 2, 3, and sleep. Deeper, more focused, relaxed. Up here, what did you think of my Bilibili hypnotic boomerang?
It's great.
You thought it was great? What was the best part of its tricks as it came back?
When it was flying in the poles.
Round the poles, right? And that dog almost got it with its tail, didn't it? Yeah. Well, give him a big round of applause. Go back to your seat. Tell you what, go ahead and sit. Come back to me here. Let's have you sit right there. Let's have you sit right there. All right. Everybody, listen to me. 1, 2, 3, and sleep. 10 times more creative, 10 times more having fun. What I'd like you to do now, if you would please, is I want you to think, if you could be any animal, real or imaginary, if you could be any animal, what that animal would be. Could be really small, could be big, even huge. It could be dumb as a rock. It could be super intelligent. But I want you to think of your favorite animal, and when you've got that, go ahead, bring your hand up, nod, head up, and nod and smile. Bring your head up, nod and smile when you have your favorite animal. Very good, all right. Here's what I'm going to have you do. In a moment, I'm going to have you open your eyes, go down these steps safely, and I'll be at the bottom. And when you get down on the grass, I'm going to count to three, snap my fingers, and you're going to become your favorite animal. And you're going to go out into the audience. Maybe it's somebody you know. Maybe it's somebody new to you. But But you're going to go to that animal because they're the ones that raised you from a young age and taught you to do things. And you're very obedient to them, and you're going to go and be with them. That's what you're going to do. You're going to be your favorite animal once I count to three down on the floor here. So go ahead, open your eyes, open your eyes, open your eyes. Go ahead, join me down here on the ground. Join me down here on the ground. Very good. Very good. There you go. There you go. Come on down. Excellent. Come on down. Come on down. Come on down. Come on down. Everybody look at me. Look at me. Look at me. One, two, three, and boom! Be the animal. Be the animal. Make the motions. That's right. Go find your owner that's raised you from a young age. That's right. Go find your owner. Who raised you from a young age? Could be, did you work? Then sit on here. Sit on here for a little bit. Go find your owner. Who? This guy?
Yep.
Very good. Go be there. Go be there. Careful. Don't make the lawyers happy. Don't make the lawyers happy. That's right. That's right. Go find your owner. Go find your owner. What kind of animal are you?
T-Rex.
Make T-Rex motions and noises.
What's noises?
That's right. That's right. Hey, your T-Rex is here. Let me step on the other side. Your T-Rex is here. How long have you had this T-Rex?
Okay. Did you turn into a T-Rex?
8 years. So this is a very young T-Rex, isn't it? Do T-Rexes do tricks? Okay, what kind of trick are you want to teach him?
I don't know.
He's just going to be a normal T-Rex around the house, right? How tall do you think a T-Rex is going to get?
Taller than me.
Taller than you, that's right. Well, best blood, I would really focus on obedience training. Okay? Now, how you train a T-Rex to be obedient, you have to be gentle, because, I mean, even at the age of 8, that T-Rex could overpower you. Isn't that true? Now, we're going to pretend like T-Rexes can talk. Do you love your owner?
Yes.
Would you ever do any harm to your owner? Would you protect her?
Yes.
Give us a protective T-Rex. Go ahead and look at the audience here. A protective T-Rex look and growl. Go ahead and give us what a T-Rex would look like. Protect. That's right. Very good. Very good. Where? Over there. Over there. Let's go ahead. There you go. There you go. You can talk even though your animal might not normally. What kind of animal are you?
A dog.
A dog. Very good. A specific breed?
No.
No. Okay. A mutt. How long have you had this dog?
For too long.
Too long? Oh my goodness. Now, as a puppy, you got this dog, right?
No, I was a few years old.
A few years old? Now, an obedient young dog, or were there difficulties?
Difficult as a puppy.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You're going to have to be more careful with your answers here pretty soon, I think. All right. So, what kind of tricks have you taught your dog?
Taught her to fetch beer and to poop in the toilet. So.
Poop in the toilet? And, I mean, does she flush?
Sometimes. We're working on that.
We're working on that. Terrific. Now, if you were to help us out, how can we train our dog to poop in the toilet?
Put treats in the toilet.
Treats in the toilet?
Yeah, and then they'll put one in there too.
And very good, very good. Well, tell you what, is there another trick that she does?
She can sit down, see?
Sit down, very good. On command?
No. Not quite there yet.
Not quite there yet either.
Yep.
Any other trick that she does do?
Beg.
She begs?
Yeah.
Well, bring her out here. To the center here. Bring her out here. Very good. Very good. Go ahead and have her be down on all fours. Have her be down.
There you go.
All right. I want you to take the microphone, bring it down there, and have her beg.
Beg.
Please don't beat me.
You better poop in the toilet next time.
Give them both a big round of applause. That is beautiful. Go ahead and sit up here with your owner on the steps. Terrific. Over here, I'm going to get to him last. T-Rex, here we go. What kind of, tell us in your human voice, what kind of animal?
I'm a velociraptor.
A velociraptor. Terrific. Well, don't let me scooch those wings. Velociraptors are the little dinosaurs that run really fast, don't they? Very good. How long is this your owner? Is this your owner?
Yeah.
Okay. How long have you had your velociraptor?
We let him spend the night last night, so his mom might be really upset that he's taking home.
Oh, this is not your velociraptor? No. You house sit every once in a while.
Yes.
Is he a well-behaved velociraptor?
My couch is all torn apart before he became a velociraptor.
Oh my goodness! And those claws, they don't help, do they?
No. Anyway, my dog is a little nervous. He's never been around a real velociraptor.
I know, but handling it pretty well. All right, what is your friend's velociraptor's name?
My friend's Sogan?
No, you said you're taking care of him.
Yeah.
For somebody else.
Yes, so
Riker. Riker, the velociraptor. Does Riker know any tricks?
That would be up to the trainer.
Oh, okay. Does Riker know any tricks? Okay, run really fast, don't run into anything, but growl at the people as you go by. Go ahead, 1, 2, 3, run fast. And growl, very good. Come back, growl some more. Yeah, give us your growl into the microphone. Yeah, that's good. All right, are you used to dogs? Is he used to dogs?
Yeah,
okay, very good. Well, why don't you run up there to the steps? Run up there to the steps. There you go. And where's your owner? Where's your owner? Oh, no. No owner. Oh, well, you come here. You come here. Very good. And to me, you look like either a monkey or a gorilla. Which is it?
Gorilla.
Oh, I love gorillas. I really do. We're going to have it be as if you can talk. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. As a gorilla, what is your favorite food?
A banana.
Bananas. Bananas are cool, aren't they?
Yes.
Have you watched humans eat bananas?
They open them the wrong way.
They do. What is the proper way to open a banana?
Not from the stem, from the bottom. Put it in, peel.
Yeah.
So then you don't get the stringinesses in your mouth.
Yeah, you don't get the strings, and you have a handle, right?
Correct.
Yeah. Why don't humans do it right?
Because they didn't evolve properly after us.
They didn't evolve properly, that's right. Now, there's another ape out there that is very popular. I want to know what you think about orangutans.
Underestimated, under acknowledged.
They are. They're very intelligent, aren't they? You know what I heard a zookeeper tell me? If any animal is going to get out of their enclosure, it's probably going to be an orangutan.
Yes, correct.
Yeah. Do you have any friends who are orangutans?
When I was younger at the zoo, I saw one take a piece of metal and reach out and grab an ice cream cone that fell and pull it up and ate it. So yeah, I would say a very smart friend.
Very smart friend. How long were you friends with that orangutan?
Probably not that year, that summer.
That summer, fantastic. But you don't get jealous, right?
No need.
Yeah, because gorillas are very smart, very social. A gorilla family, oh, that rocks, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
And y'all strong.
Very strong.
Very strong. What is your biggest feat of strength so far?
Probably upper body.
Upper body?
Yeah.
What have you done, upper body? There's a little gorilla over here, just scooted up a bunch of grass, and probably gonna throw it, right?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Or eat it.
Or eat it, either one. And the final question is, what has been your biggest feat of strength to show others how strong you are?
Protection. Can protect really well.
Very good. Go back up and join your friends up there. Give them all a big round of applause, everybody. Fantastic. Just for me, just for the rest of the show, when I count to three, go back deeply into hypnosis. One, two, three, and sleep. Deeper, more focused, relaxed, terrific. You're all back to being human. You remember what your owner said about you, and after the show, you can take care of it on your own terms. But you're all fantastic. Give them a round of applause, them and their owners. Fantastic. Go ahead, open your eyes. Go back up into the first four seats up here. The first four seats, doesn't matter where you sat before. There you go. I'm sorry. First five seats. There you go. There you go. There you go. Excellent. Yeah, if you two would come over here just so we can keep you together. So come on over here and have a seat. Yeah, I know. Other skits will work for you. Okay? Okay? So, on the count of three, go back deeply in hypnosis. One, two, three, and sleep. Deeper, more focused, relaxed. Give them another round of applause, everybody. Fantastic. All right. So here is what I want you to do. In a moment, would you get Born to be Wild up? That would be great. In a moment, I want you to now think about your favorite performance vehicle. If you could own any vehicle at all, motorcycle, car, truck, race car, farm equipment, I don't care what it is, if you could own a vehicle for its style, for its speed, for its power, I don't care, what would that vehicle be? And on the count of three, have it be as if you're sitting in that vehicle. One, two, three. You got that vehicle? Bring your head up, keep your eyes closed, keep your eyes closed. You are feeling great, you are feeling good, and you're in your vehicle. Go ahead, reach forward and turn it on. Go ahead, turn it on, that's right, there you go. Oh, feel that power, it is just waiting. Go ahead, check your mirror, get your mirrors in place, the big mirror in front of you, the two side mirrors. Go ahead and get everything in place, that's right. And check yourself out in the mirror. Make sure you're looking good. Make sure you're styling, that's right. And go ahead, put your hand on the wheel and ease your way out. Ease your way out, that's right. We're in the town of Missouri Valley, Iowa, and you ease yourself out. You're going to I-29. Go ahead and get your vehicle going here. And I'm going to ask you what you're driving. Go ahead and tell me. What are you driving, young man?
A Tesla.
What? A Tesla. Beautiful. What are you driving, man?
An Equinox.
Equinox. Beautiful. What are you driving?
I'm driving anything.
Okay, you just go ahead and just rock out to the music, okay? Fantastic. And what are you driving?
Dodge Ram pickup.
Dodge Ram, that's right. It has power, doesn't it? It's got the Hemi in it, doesn't it?
Yes.
All right, ease on out, ease on out. We're going to head off to I-29. And we get on I-29, and we're going to go north just for the heck of it. And go ahead, and the traffic is light today. Just go ahead and rock out to the music and drive on down the road. Drive on down the road, and hey, next to you is your favorite principal or instructor. Go ahead, look out the side, look out the side, and there they are. Go ahead and wave to them, wave to them. This is a person that was surprisingly very important in your life, and smile and give them a thumbs up, because you are just styling here, that's right. And then give it a little gas, you start to pull away, but doggone it, if they don't pull up next to you and they're grinning at you, and then they ease in front of you. Well, you're not gonna take that. Speed up, put the gas down. Put the gas, catch up with them, that's right. And you go along and you're doing 80, that's fine, 85, 90. It's starting to get just, you feel that rumble, you feel that power, 95, 100. And all of a sudden they put on the brakes and take an exit, but you are still going down I-29. The power is there, it is exciting. And all of a sudden in your rear view mirror, you see those lights. Oh my gosh, you got caught. You got caught. Ease it off, ease it off. Drive over to the shoulder of the road. Pull over to the shoulder of the road. And there you are, you're stopped. And this County Mountie has a reputation. If you can give her a good story, she might let you go. So come up with your best story. It doesn't even have to be true. You're trying to get out of a ticket. 1, 2, 3, you've got the idea. Go ahead and raise your head up so we can see you. And I'm gonna save you for last. Young man, why were you speeding in my county?
Get to where I wanted quicker.
Get where you wanted to go quicker. Where did you want to go?
The museum?
Where's this museum?
In Iowa.
In Iowa? Well, you're almost to South Dakota. What's going on here? Got you. She got you, didn't she? You're probably going to get a ticket. All right, over here. Now, you got a female sheriff here. You got a shot. Go ahead. She says, why were you speeding in my county?
Trying to get to the hospital.
My goodness, what's wrong?
Someone just had a baby.
Just had a baby? That's wonderful. How long have you known this person?
My whole life.
Your whole life? That's fantastic. Well, I'm going to let you go. Just don't speed the rest of the way, all right?
Okay.
All right. Why were you speeding in my county?
My mom was having trouble walking, and I have to get to her house real quick so I can get her to the hospital because the ambulance isn't making it there in time.
Not going to make it in time? What's wrong with your mother?
She currently suffers with liver cancer, so every now and then her potassium and magnesium drops, and then she loses all mobility, so I need to get there as soon as possible quickly.
Oh, my goodness. I'm sorry. Tell you what. I'll get in front of you. I'll clear the way. You just give me the address, and I'll make sure we get there. And you give her the address, and she gives you an escort all the way to where you say your mother lives. Just go ahead and wave goodbye to her and thank her. Give her a thumbs up. That's right. Give them all a big round of applause, everybody. Fantastic. Creative ideas. Everybody, go ahead and look at me. 1, 2, 3, and sleep. You have all been wonderful. I'm going to give you what I call a hypnotic gift. This is no longer entertainment. This is my gift to you for you to benefit from for the rest of your life. What I would like you to do is this. I'm not going to ask what this is. It's nobody else's business what this is. In the privacy of your own mind, where it's always going to stay, I want you to think of one little thing that if you could do it, feel it, or believe it, your life would improve. Not, I want to be a better person. No, that's way too big. But of all the little things that you could do, feel, or believe to improve your life, what would that one little thing be? And when you have that, just raise your head up, nod, and smile. One little thing that if you could do it, feel it, or believe it, your life would improve. Very good. Excellent. Now, in a moment, I'm going to help you emerge from hypnosis. As you emerge from hypnosis, this one little thing is going to go deeper and deeper into your subconscious mind, and it is going to reside there. It will not become a compulsion. It cannot get in the way of the rest of your life. It's just that little reminder of if you do feel or believe this thing, your life will be better. And here's the really cool thing. After you have this first little thing in place, you now have the skill to pick another little thing and put that in place. It can be sequential and build off of everything else, or it could be something totally different. That doesn't matter. But this is a resource you have for the rest of your life. So go ahead, raise your head up if it's not already, and open your eyes, open your eyes, open your eyes. Go ahead, stand up. Stand up. Spread out a little bit. Keep facing the audience. Spread out a little bit because some people like to stretch. As I count from 1 to 5, you're going to fully emerge from hypnosis at the count of 5, if not before. But the one thing I want you to do, the last hypnotic thing I want you to do, is to put your foot firmly on the floor, your left foot, put it firmly on the stage, and have it be as if it is stuck there. Stuck like glue. Check it out really quick. You're not able to move it right now, but when you are fully immersed from hypnosis, you're going to be able to move that foot, and that way I know you're out of hypnosis, plus a couple of other things I look for. Go ahead, look at me, look at me, look at me. As I count from 1 to 5, you're going to fully emerge from hypnosis by 5, if not before. Ready? 1. Let that energy come up your body. As you felt yourself relax before, feel that middle of the afternoon energy come up your body. You're feeling good. You're feeling great. You feel it come up into your torso, up into your shoulders, your neck, down your arms, up into your head, and you feel your head clear, returning to that conscious, logical state, remembering the show at least as well as any other creative thing that you've done. 2, for the next couple of 3 days, even longer if you like. The color red can be a gentle but persistent reminder to let this one little thing come into reality to you. Red, 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 red. It's the color of a taillight, stoplight, red of a neon sign. But whenever you see it, it reminds you to put this one little in place, let it grow, not as a compulsion. It will never get in the way of anything else. And then when you have that in place, you can put another little thing in place after that. 3, let that energy return to you. Even though we had just a few brief minutes doing hypnosis today, you feel wonderful. You're going to have a fine rest of the afternoon, go to sleep tonight, feel great, wake up refreshed in the morning. 4, preparing to be fully out of hypnosis, getting ready at the count of 5 from a big round of applause from everybody here. And 5, fully immersed from hypnosis, big round of applause. Big round of applause for your friends and family. I'm going to go ahead, check you out as you leave here. Go ahead and get your shoes on.